Let's get started our lesson. Today we are going to solve the beam with a movable hinge support and fixed hinge supports. Please draw this beam. The beam has length 40 beam. This is the axis of the beam. Here the movable hinge support, at point A. In this section is the fixed hinge support. This distance (2 meters) and this distance 4 meters. The external movement acts in this section, external movement M. Please draw the external movement. M is equal to 20 kilonewtons multiplied by meters. And the distributed load acts on this distance with a constant intensity Q. Please draw the distributed forces. U is equal to 10 kilonewtons divided by meters. Solution. The one step, step one. We find the reactions of the supports. At point A, is a movable hinge support, and there is only one vertical reaction of this support. Please show vertical reaction. We don't know right direction, and therefore we direct RA up, usually up. RA. This point, point B, is called fixed hinge support. There are two reactions of this support. Horizontal reaction, HB, and vertical reaction, RB. This is a distributed load, and we will find the resultant force of this distributed force, distributed load. The resultant force is applied in the middle of this force, in the middle of this distance. In the center of gravity of this rectangle. Please show the resultant force, which is called RQ. RQ. This force is equal to the area of this rectangle with sides Q and 4 meters. 10 multiplied by 4, we receive 40 kilonewtons. Then we draw axis Z. Z is the axis of the beam. Z and Y, the vertical axis Y. And then we write the equations of equilibrium. At first, sum of projections of all forces on the z-axis. Projections of all forces on z-axis. Only one force, HB, is projected on the axis Z. HB is equal to zero. Since all external forces are perpendicular to the X of the beam, and the horizontal reaction will be always be zero. And in the following tasks, we will not draw this reaction, because it always be equal to zero. Then we write equations of movements, applying the first rule of science. First rule of science. If the force creates the movement counterclockwise, m of this force is positive, greater than zero. If force creates the movement clockwise, m less than zero. To find the movement of the force must be multiplied by the shoulder. Force multiplied by the shoulder. What is the shoulder? Shoulder is the distance between the line of action of the force and the point about which the movements is calculated. For example, about B. This is a force, this is a shoulder. The external moment does not need to be multiplied by the shoulder. Let's draw the sum of movements about point A. Sum of movement about A is equal to zero, because this is a equilibrium equation. The first force which creates a movement about A, RB. RB creates the movement counterclockwise about A, counterclockwise. And therefore, RB is the movement of RB is positive. RB multiply shoulder 4 plus 2, 6 meters. AQ creates movement clockwise about A, and therefore movement of RQ is negative, minus RQ multiply 2 plus 2, 4 meters. And the external movement M, without shoulder, only M, minus clockwise minus M is equal to zero. RB multiply 6 minus 4 multiply by 4 minus 20 is equal to zero. And RB is equal to 160 plus 20 divided by 6 is equal to 30 kilonewtons. We write this value in the scheme of the beam. 30 kilonewtons. Let's write the sum of moments about point B. minus arc A multiply shoulder minus clockwise minus R A multiply 6 minus M minus M clockwise and RQ creates the movement about A, about B clockwise, counterclockwise, counterclockwise plus RQ multiply this distance 2 meters is equal to 0. And RA is equal to (40)-2 - (20)/6 and we receive 10 kilonewtons. Write on the scheme 10 kilonewtons. Then it is necessary to check the found reactions of the supports. We write the sum of projections of all forces on the axis y. RA with plus RA minus RQ plus RB is equal to 10 minus 40 plus 40 is equal to 0. That's right.